So that's the type of thing I like to look for. Try to have a chromatic line and find triads, minor or major triads that can fit that. This little motif that is transposed. Right here it's 6-7, which is really 5-2. So now instead of looking at F7 as 1-7, you really make it sound like a 5-4. Okay. The approach notes, we've discussed about those approach notes. So even though we're on a dominant 7, you can approach 1 with D natural. Now notice the placement of that note. For the first 3 bars, he plays on the end of 4. That's really a motivic playing right there. So you don't think about it when you play, but you think about it when you practice. That's the type of thing you have to think about when you're practicing. So on D7, to make it sound altered, you can play the B flat major triad, which gives us the B flat, so the flat 13 that we talked about, the D, which is the root, and then F natural, which is going to be the sharp 9. Alright, and the melody is really clearly stating that. Okay, so that's, so here is playing this triad. So C augmented over B flat 7. We're on A minor. So it's targeting C on the downbeat. I'm talking in B flat. So the 3rd, the 5th, then the 9th, and the 11th. Okay, so really transpose that phrase in different keys. Okay, in F, so targeting the 3rd of the 2 minor. Okay, so here, D minor triad. And really, what I hear, really, it's A triad here. So at the beginning, he's playing behind the beat, and then he rushes a little bit to come back on the beat. What is this again? Flat 13, he's altering B flat, going to A flat, and going to G.